Hi there, it's Marlene Hillema from imagemaven.com. In this video blog post, I'm going to show you a couple of different ways that you can add drama and texture to an otherwise boring, dull, cloudy sky. Now, I'm not talking about cloudy when it's sunny and cloudy and you can see blue. I'm talking about those overcast days where you don't even want to go out of the house. Now, hopefully I'm going to change your mind about going for photo walks on days like this, because these effects are really striking. All right, let's get started. Now, the first method involves using your iPhone and an iPhone app. And the second method involves shooting with an in-camera creative filter. So on your iPhone or your Android device, download the Snapseed app. And when you open it up, you search for some photos. Go with this one, and you can see that it's a pretty flat sky. It has a few things going on, but not too much. A little bit of light in the bottom. Click the pencil icon, go down to the filter section, click on drama, and immediately you see the result. You go from this to this in one click. Now, if you find the filter strength too high, you can manually change that. But I don't mind it at 90. But what I do like is I like to raise the saturation back to normal so that I get the color back. If you take too much saturation out, you get a black and white photo. If that's what you want, that's fine. But I prefer to have, in this particular case, a color photo. And that's all there is to it. When you're happy, click the check mark and hit save. And when you save, you can save with three versions: export, save a copy, or plain old save. Okay, let's try another image. Looks very flat on first blush. Click the pencil, go down to drama, and immediately you see that we have some beautiful cloud formations in there. I mean, when you walk into a scene like this on your photo walk, you're going to think, ooh, what a dull day. But when you add a little drama, you can make spectacular photos. So again, I will raise that saturation back to zero. And there we go, before and after. Now, if you like to try other versions of the filter, you can do so as well. Some of them are really dramatic. But for the average sky, I prefer drama too, which happens to be the default. Now here's a few more examples of using this Snapseed drama filter at the skate park. As you know, I do a lot of skateboarding and skateboarding photography. Now sometimes the days are not perfectly sunny and with a clear blue sky or those beautiful puffy clouds, but I actually don't mind it when it's overcast because I love to use the drama filter. And when I use the drama filter, it also makes the concrete look a little bit grungy too. And that totally suits the subject of a skateboard park. Mostly I'm posting these on Instagram, so they never really get enlarged very much, but I have on occasion enlarged these quite big and they turn out actually quite beautiful. Try and experiment when there's puffy clouds in the sky and see what that looks like. All right, now I'm going to talk about the second method to creating dramatic skies. Now this method involves using the in-camera creative filters in my Lumix GM1 camera. Okay, first things first, you want to get into the creative filters mode. which has the little artist palette. Now I like to use the Impressive Art Filter. So I scroll across, hit Menu Select, and there it is. Now, as you can probably guess, it doesn't look great for skin tone. This is not the filter to be taking portraits with. Another thing you can do is change the saturation of the filter. Hit the WB dial and scroll through the different saturation levels. All right, let's take a look at some other real-world examples of this filter being used. Now, these methods might seem a little over the top for general everyday photo use. You know, they're not realistic, but if you're into the creative side of editing and you like to push the limits of your photography, then try them out. My personal favorite is the Snapseed method using the iPhone app, and you can also use this on the iPad too, of course. What I do is I take my images from my camera and I use Wi-Fi to transfer them into my iPad or my iPhone and I edit them there. And it's great if you're on location too, like when I'm at the skate park, I often shoot, transfer, and upload to Instagram right when I'm there. All right, well, let me know what you think in the comments and I look forward to seeing your experiments. See you next time. It's Marlene Hillema from imagemaven.com. Hey, and if you like this video, please subscribe. That way you won't miss any of my future episodes.